Okay, here's my solution. So what I'm doing is I'm using a global variable, which is not a great habit to get into, but it works in this simple case, to store the index into the list, basically which server we're on. And I started at -1, so that the first time I incremented it, it increments to 0. So we'll be at position 0. I'm using the global keyword here, which basically tells Python to use the global n defined outside this function, instead of making a new variable called n. If I didn't have this global n, this line would raise an exception saying n is not defined. And then what I do is I return the index into the list of servers, the correct position. So, and the way we do this is we say n modulo length of servers. So the length of servers is 4. And if you don't know how the mod operator works, basically what it does is it says, give me the remainder of doing the division. So what this means is we take n divided by length servers, and then we take the remainder of that. That's what modulo does. So if it's 0, we say 4 goes into 0, 0 times. If n is 1, we say 4 goes into 0, or 4 goes into 1, 0 times with a remainder of 1. And so we get index 1. And so as n increments, you know, once n is 5, we say, you know, length servers 4 goes into 5 1 time with a remainder of 1 again. So it loops over. So if we were to give this a whirl, it would print out something like this. Okay, so if we go ahead and run this, we see our output server 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. So simple enough. That's how round robin load balancing works. Like I said, you probably won't have to implement this anytime soon, but there you go.